Now, class 10 physics students, we have finished two chapters. Chapter 1 electricity and chapter 2 magnetic effect of current. And in the whole year, we have to finish 5 chapters, students. So, we are much ahead. No need to worry much. So students, I want to do some questions with you which are out in board. On page 5, there is a series of questions. I am trying to give answer of those questions to you. By what other name is unit joule per coulomb called? Joule upon coulomb, student. Question 1 on page 5. Question number 1 of electricity chapter. It wants joule per coulomb is known as what name? So, student, it is volt. Joule per coulomb is volt, because you know that volt is equal to work done upon charge. Unit of work done is joule and charge is coulomb. So charge per coulomb is measured in volt, student. So its answer is volt. Which of the following statement correctly defines a volt? A volt is joule per ampere. A volt is joule per coulomb. Answer of second is hidden in first. Question second, it is volt is joule per coulomb. A volt is joule per coulomb. It is option D, not joule per ampere. What do the letter PD stand for? Potential. PD stand for potential difference. This device is used to measure PD, voltmeter. Question 3. PD means potential difference, and which is measured by voltmeter. In this way, on which V is related to students. Question 4. What is meant by saying that electric potential at a point is 1 volt? The electric potential at a point is 1 volt means a work of 1 joule is done in bringing unit positive charge, means 1 coulomb charge, from one point to the other, students. Electric potential means from one point to other it will be potential difference. Or from infinity to that point in the electric field is the potential. If potential difference is asked, then work done of 1 joule will be done in bringing 1 coulomb charge from one point to other. But here potential is asked, so work done in bringing unit positive charge is 1 coulomb charge from infinity to that point in electric field. Question 4. Is over. Question 4 I have answered. Now question 5 is, how much work is done when 1 coulomb charge moves against a potential of 1 volt? 1 coulomb charge is moved with a 1 volt, and here is work done, so work is 1 into 1, that is 1 joule. It is question number 5. What is SI unit of potential difference? Volt. Question 6. SI unit of PD, potential difference, is volt. SI. How much work is done in moving charge of 2 coulomb across 2 points having potential difference of 12 volt? Work done is equal to 3 into 6, that is 24 joules. Question 7 is W is equal to V into C. V is how much here? 12 volt and charge is 2 coulomb, so it is 24 joule. Now number 8, what is unit of electric charge? It is coulomb. And you know it is charge offered by a large number of electrons, that is 6.25 × 10⁻¹⁸ cluster of electrons. Now students, define 1 coulomb charge. Oh, 1 coulomb charge is that much charge which is offered by 1 coulomb charge in the bringing of which 1 joule is work done in an electric field with potential of 1 volt. Anyway, you can define this students. 1 coulomb is equal to 1 joule upon 1 volt. Filling the blanks with suitable word, potential difference is measured in volt by using a voltmeter placed in parallel across a compartment. Copper is a good conductor, plastic is a bad conductor. Thus, we did 10 questions here, students, and still we have much time to proceed on. So, these are very short answer type of question. Now, we are starting question 11, which is short answer type question. What is meant by conductor and insulators? Conductors means substances which allow charges or electric current to pass through them are called conductors, and insulators which do not allow to pass through them the charges or electric current are known as insulators. Example, two examples are required, conductors or silver and copper, because silver is best conductor, copper is also a good conductor below silver. Two insulator, one insulator is plastic, other is dry wood. So students, question 11 is example. Which of the following are conductor and which are insulators? Many substances are given here in question 12. Students, I am listing in two heads, conductors and insulators. In conductors, students, sulfur is an insulator. Sulfur, PHU, sulfur is insulator, and silver is good conductor. Conductor is good conductor. Here copper is also given, copper is good conductor, copper silver. Cotton is bad conductor or insulator. Cotton. Aluminium, whose symbol is A, good conductor. Air, bad conductor. Nichrome is not insulator, but it is not a good conductor, it is a bad conductor. Conductor and which are insulator. Nichrome also conducts nichrome. Gold has a large resistance. Graphite is good conductor. Aluminium. Graphite, paper. Paper is here. Porcelain is here. Porcelain. Mercury is here, good conductor. Mercury.
Na or CO, not a good conductor. Mica is white conductor. Bakelite bad conductor, polythene bad conductor, and manganese is what? It is an alloy, so it might be considered good conductor, manganese.
So this is list of conductor and insulators in question 12. Students,
now it is about, let us take it.
Now students, question 12 is over. Manganese is a,
no, not very good conductor, but it is conductor.
But in what do you understand by term electric potential? Electric potential at a point means it is the measure of work done in bringing unit positive charge from infinity to a point in an electric field. What is unit of electric potential? Its unit is volt. State relation between potential difference, work done in charge move. So V is equal to W upon C. So the potential is equal to work done upon charge. Charge move. And its second part of question 14 is calculate work done in moving charge of 4 coulomb, C is 4, 4 coulomb to students from a potential point at 220 volt to another point at 230. So difference of potential is 230 minus 220, that is 10 volt, so it will be 40 joule. 230 minus 220 will be 10 volt, so we will take here 10 students. It is question number 14. Name a device that helps to measure potential difference across a conductor. I told you voltmeter. How much energy is transferred by a 12 volt power supply to each coulomb of charge which it moves around the circuit? 12 volt power each coulomb charge. So V into 1, my 12 into 1 will be 12 joule. So it will, energy will be 12 joule. Question 15. A and B are over students. Now long answer, short answer type of questions are finished. Now video is about 14 minutes.